Hello everyone, welcome. In the previous video, I started re-recording Nepali grammar using standard romanization. We covered pronouns, and in this video, we will talk about possessive forms of pronouns. Let's begin. So first person pronouns, if you remember from the last video, they are I is ma, we is hami. And when we make possessive for these pronouns, we add ro. But the form of the possessive is not regular, so ma plus ro becomes mero, mero, and hami plus ro becomes hamro. And then there's one more rule which we'll cover in the next slide. The possessive form that we saw in the previous slide with ro is when the object is singular and male or neutral. So this is when we use mero or hamro. If the object is female, then the possessive form will take ri, meri or hamri. Similarly, if the object is plural and or it deserves good amount of respect or the person deserves good amount of respect, then we will use ra, mera, hamra. So here's there are some examples. Mero ghar, my house, because ghar is neutral. Meri ama, my mother, because mother is female. And mera didi haru, notice that didi haru, although female, because it's plural, then it becomes mera. Mera because it's plural. And then mera baba, you say mera baba, because for father you are showing respect. If we were using hamro, hamro ghar, our house, hamri ama would be our mother, and hamra didi haru would be our sisters. Second person. Now, a note in second person, we use both the ro, ri, ra form that you saw for the first person pronouns, and also there is the ko, ki, ka. So, the ko, ki, ka is the more standard way of making possessive. The ro, ri, ra is the special case that applies to some second person pronouns, and as we saw, the first person pronouns. Okay, and in the case of plural, we always use ko, ki, ka. Some examples here. With ton and timi, we use the ro, ri, ra construction. So ton plus ro becomes tero, just the way mo plus ro became mero, and timi plus ro becomes timro, just the way hami plus ro became hamro. Okay, so timi, ton timi, it's similar to mo hami. In examples here, timro ghar, your house, timro ghar, your house, because ghar is neutral. Teri ama, your mother. Now, generally, I don't recommend you using teri ama, because teri comes from ton, and I don't suggest you use the ton pronoun that much. But anyway, if we were to say ton or tero teri, so this would be the construction. Timra didi haru, your sisters. And for the cases where you show a lot of respect, tapai and hazur, you only use the ko ki ka, okay, ko ki ka. So it would be tapai ko naam, your name. Tapai ko naam ke ho, what is your name? Tapai ko naam. Hazur haruko ghar, hazur haruko ghar, your home, hazur haruko ghar. And if it is a female object, then that would be tapai ki ama would be your mother. In third person, we use the ko, ki, ka construction in all cases. But there are some examples here which you will notice that we also need to add something in between. Like u, we change it to usko. We don't say uko, we say usko. We soften the pronoun u by adding so, usako. And we don't say usako that much, we say usko, usko. The so in the middle is pronounced like half. Similarly for uni, we change ni, uni, the ni part of uni to no. So uni becomes unko. And it's not unako, we don't usually say unako, we say unko, unko, as if no is half in this case. Okay, so u becomes usko and uni becomes unko. And for uha, waha, the respectful cases, so you just add ko. And for yo is similar to u, so you make it yesko. So note that it's written yesako, but we say yesko. Uniharu, uhaharu, uhaharu, all of them, you add ko. So the general form is here. The possessive form depends on what the object is. If the object is singular and male or neutral, so we use ko that you saw in the previous slide. If the object is female, then you use ki. And if the object is plural or respectable, then you use ka. So usko ghar, his house, because the object is singular and neutral. Unki ama, her mother. It can also be his mother. Unki ama, singular female object. And waha ka didi haru, his sisters or her sisters. Uniharuko school, their school. For the demonstrative pronouns, this, that, these, those. So yo becomes yesko. Tio becomes tesko. I, ini become inko. Ti, tini become tinko. I becomes inko. Iniharu becomes iniharuko. And ti becomes tinko. And tiniharu becomes tiniharuko. And for female object, the ko would become ki. And for plural or respectable object, the ko would be replaced by ka. This is the vocabulary covered in this video. I will pause for some time. Thank you for listening. See you next time.